Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirisha Singh. I am a consultant dermatologist and cosmetic dermatologist. Since we are coming up to monsoons, we thought it's a good time to discuss the common skin infections that one experiences during this particular time of the year. The common infections during this time of the year are fungal infections and bacterial infections. The high humidity in monsoon season promotes sweating from the body, and the accumulation of moisture on the skin, leaving the skin damp, provides a potent fungi to multiply, grow and cause skin rashes, which are extremely itchy in nature. We find that a lot of people present with fungal infections, especially in the folds of the body, that is between the toes, between the fingers, in the groin area, in the armpits and in the folds of the skin underneath the breast tissues. These areas are particularly prone because sweat tends to stay on the skin for a longer period of time on these areas and hence promotes the growth of the fungus. The infection appears as a red rash, which can be roundish. It is usually fairly well defined, that is, it has a well defined edge to it, and it is usually quite itchy in nature. The treatment of the fungal infection depends upon the extent of the infection. If it is a very mild infection and involving a very small area of the skin, then an antifungal ointment or cream will do the trick. If, however, the fungal infection is very widespread and involves large parts of the body, then one may need to take use of antifungal tablets. In addition, it is also very important to keep the area dry, as humid-free as possible. That is, after you take a bath or after you go for a swim and come back, try and dry out the area to avoid the accumulation of moisture in the area. In the nights, it's advisable to wear a loose cotton or linen undergarment and a loose cotton or linen night clothes, so that these parts of the skin get well ventilated and there's as little accumulation of moisture as possible in these areas. There are also a lot of antifungal powders available in the market. These antifungal powders can be used as a prevention before one develops a fungal infection, especially in the body folds. Very often I recommend these antifungal dusting powders to people who are a bit overweight, have a poor nutritional status, or they suffer from problems like diabetes, which predisposes them to getting a fungal infection. Even those people who are apparently completely normal but who have had fungal infections every year during the monsoon season could be a candidate for use of a preventative antifungal dusting powder this time of the year. The other common problem that one sees during this time of the year is bacterial skin infections. Bacterial skin infections are very common because at this time of the year, because of the humidity, we all tend to scratch on the skin. Scratching of the skin causes minute abrasions of the skin, which are really invisible to the naked eye. But however, these abrasions are large enough for bacteria, which normally only sit on the surface of the skin, to penetrate deeper into the skin and cause an infection. This infection can appear as a small red pimple-like lesion. It may become larger or it may become a red patch. The biggest difference between a bacterial and a fungal skin infection is that bacterial skin infections usually tend to be more painful in contrast to a fungal skin infection, which tends to be itchy. The treatment of the bacterial skin infections is fairly straightforward and simple. If it is a small area of infection, an antibiotic cream or ointment would do the trick. However, if the infection is extensive, or if the infection affects dangerous areas of the body, in particular the head and the neck area, then it is advisable to see a dermatologist and get a prescription for an oral antibiotic. Before you stop the antibiotic, I would strongly recommend that you see a dermatologist, because very often if the antibiotic is stopped earlier than is necessary, then there is a recurrence of the bacterial infection. And you might find that you are not only needing to step up on the quality of antibiotic to be used, but also the duration for which the antibiotic is to be needed can increase if it is stopped prematurely. If you have any further queries on skin infections during the monsoon season, feel free to contact me. My contact details are given in the description box below. Thank you.